Hey everybody, Shane Severson here, Legacy Realty, and I want to come to you on this Tuesday and talk about affordability of houses. Now here's the deal, why is this so important? I feel like there's a lot of fear in the market right now and has been for years and years on the idea of affordability. Let me explain what I'm saying. Maybe you have a relative, a loved one, a really good friend, and they say you would be crazy to buy a home at these kind of prices. There's no way people can afford to pay $600,000 for just your average 3-4 bedroom, 2-3 bath home. The prices have to slow down. They have to stop because people simply cannot afford it. Affordability. And because of that, there's fear in the market, this idea that the market has to drop because people can't afford it. Out of 10 conversations I have, at least half of those are around that concept and the idea of maybe I should hold off on buying because of affordability. I was in a class last week and it blew my mind. I've shared this before, but I want to talk about it again on this Tips Tuesday. And the idea is around a DTI, meaning debt to income ratio. What that means is the percentage of your income versus your debt, and it comes up with a debt to income ratio. Lenders have used pretty much the same debt to income ratio for years, since the 70s. I've been doing it 22 years. We had almost the exact same debt to income ratios 22 years ago as we do today. So the question is, if the affordability is changing, if we're getting too expensive and people can't afford it, then our debt to income ratios would become tighter. There was a chart in this class that I was in, and it blew my mind. Since the 70s, it charted what the affordability of homes are since the 70s, and it's almost exactly what it was back in the 70s, the same. How can that be? How could you afford a $600,000 home just as easy as what your parents or so 20, 25 years ago bought a home for $50,000? Now, let me explain a couple different things because you're going to hear from people, I bought my house at 50 grand. There's no way people can afford this. Here's the deal to keep in mind. When your parents or grandparents bought their home at $50,000 20, 30 years ago, whatever it was, income for a household, and I don't know, I haven't looked at all these statistics, but we could look into this together. If you don't believe me, give me a call. We'll do the research together. Their family income was probably $20,000, $30,000, $40,000 for a family income. So you're making $30,000 to buy at $50,000. Those were the numbers back then. Today, those numbers are closer to $500,000 to $600,000, and your household income may be something like 70, 80, 100,000. Now here's the other big difference. When they bought, they probably bought at an interest rate anywhere, talk to them, 8%. I've sold rates way back in the day at 12%. I've heard of people taking 13, 14% interest rates. Those interest rates at 13, 12, 10 are astronomically higher than today at a 3, 3.25, 3.5% interest rate. The people I talk to with lots of money are like, this is free money. I might as well just use it. So those are the differences. Your income is way higher than it was then. Your interest rates and your payments, not payments, but your interest rate, so the percentage of what you're borrowing versus your payment is way, way lower, which equals that out and makes it almost exactly the same, if not even a little more affordable than it was maybe for your grandparents to buy. Great example, great story I'll end with. I just had a rental application that came onto my desk for one of my rentals. Can I tell you, their income for the household was just under $11,000 a month, 11 grand. For those of you who are like, wow, who would rent at 11 grand? There are people everywhere. That is the norm today, which is what I'm saying. Affordability today is about the exact same as back in the 70s. If you have been fearful, if you have been sold a bill of goods that maybe you shouldn't buy because the market's going to drop, I'm telling you, we're going to be looking in another 20 years. Prices will have gone up even more, and the affordability will probably be about the same. Hope that helps. Reach out if you're looking to buy. Maybe you want to sell and move up. Give me a call. I'd love to chat with you. God bless. We'll see you next Tuesday.